Hello there, this is Ashraf from Zenon Studios. Today I want us to look at how we can draw an Archimedean spiral in AutoCAD. Well, I've drawn a circle of radius 40 and I'm going to draw a cone up here. So I'm going to snap over there and also snap over this. Perfect. I'm going to give this cone. I'm going to give this cone a height of, let's say, 80. And then I can close this off just like that. Don't need that line. Perfect. So I'm going to draw lines in here. Now we need to divide this circle into two equal parts. So there are many ways of doing that. I'm simply going to come over here, then I'm going to grab this tool divide, and I'm going to select my object, and I'm going to say I want to divide this into 12 segments. It has AutoCAD has divided, but I can't see that, so all I can do is type DD P type and hit enter, and I'm going to select that and hit OK. Perfect. And those are my 12 divisions. So all I can do now is so if your application is not snapping to those points, simply come over here and make sure node is checked. So click there. So I want to connect there, and I'm taking all this all the way to the apex. So do the same for this point. This has a problem, guys. My CAD is a little slow because I'm rendering some designs in the background. It's okay, we can continue. So perfect, then I can now select these and simply mirror them on this other side. I'm mirroring them the wrong way. Mirror there. Perfect. Now all I need to do now is to divide this edge into 12 parts. Okay, so how can I do that? Do the same, come over here, select divide, hit this line and say divide it into 12 segments. Now those look too big, so I'm going to type DD, P type, enter. Then I'm going to change this to, let's say, 2, enter. Perfect. That is okay. So you're going to draw lines from here to there. And perfect. So since I have this, I can now draw my Archimedean spiral. I'm assuming the spiral is beginning from my left hand side. So come over here to draw. Grab your spline. So the first point of this plane is going to be that, the second this, the third that, this, that, this. Then we shall head over to this point there, then continue our journey up there. Then that, this, this, and finally the apex right there. So when you reach the end point, As you can see, the command line is saying end, which is the tangency. So hit T on your keyboard, hit enter, and click the same point to come out of that command. Perfect. But as you can tell, one part of this spline has to be hidden, so I need to break that spline at the intersection. So come over here, break at a point, and I'm going to break this at this point right here, so I can make this, I can outline that part of the spline, turn on line weights, and then make this hidden. So come over here to other, then load, then you're going to load, I want to use that. Okay, so select it again and come over here and say cut that. Now as you can see, that is too big, so I can say LTS, which stands for line type scale factor, and it is 1, so you can reduce it all the way to 0.2. and as you can see, our hidden line is coming out there very well. All I can simply go on and reduce it further to 0.05, and there you have it. Perfect. Well, you can decide to use a different line. Now, how can we transfer this to our plan? So simply you're going to draw lines in here. Now to make this faster, I'm going to simply use the polar command. So I'm going to draw a line over here. I'm going to select it. Okay, I can simply type array, then I'm going to say array polar, then so center point is this one, and then it will draw some polar lines in there, but you can see it has drawn 6. I want 12, so 12, enter, it will give me 12, so I'll simply close array. But as you can see now, this is one item, so I'm going to select it and hit X on my keyboard to explode it into single items. Perfect. Now all these are single items. Perfect. Now our spiral started from this point, which is actually down here, and since this face is visible, that means it's down over here, because we assume that you're standing down here to see the front elevation. So that means that this part of the spiral is actually down here like this. So simply grab your line, come over to this point, and drop it down to this line here. Perfect. Grab this one, drop it to this point right there. Then for this one that is at the midline, you're going to simply follow it up through up to the end, come over here, bring it to the center of the circle, and you're going to radiate it to that point right there. So I'm going to use my arc, grab this, this is my center point, then this will be my radius, and I want to bring this right there. Perfect. So you can keep track of these points by putting their points. I don't know if that makes sense. Yeah, so come back and grab this guy. We are still down this side, so that guy is right over there. Then come and grab this one, and there. Then come over and grab finally this guy right here. That guy is going to be right there. Perfect. And I can grab my spline, start over from here, come there, here, there, here, and now there. Hit T on your keyboard, click the same point to end your. Perfect. Now, for purposes of time, I'm leaving the upper part to you. So simply grab those points, drop them down, and you will come up with something like that. Perfect. Thank you for watching. See you in my next tutorial. Like and subscribe to this channel for more videos just like this one.